Hello guys, what's up? This is AJ. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make an enemy also search and find bullets and make an enemy only able to shoot after collecting these bullets. So before that, let me just clear one thing up. I set the chasing distance here to 20 and attacking distance to 8. Now if we hit play, the player is within chasing distance of our enemy. So the enemy will move towards the player, stop at a distance and start shooting. So everything's working fine now. But if we change the chasing distance to 50 and the attacking distance to 25, now if I hit play, the player is already inside attacking distance, so the enemy won't be trying to chase the player or move towards the player. It's just starting to shoot, but the projectiles are not directed towards the player. This is because we haven't set our enemy to look at our player before attacking. So let's just clear that up. So inside our enemy controller script over here, I'm just going to add this transform dot look at player dot transform when our enemy is able to shoot as well. That's just when our enemy is within or our player is within the attacking distance, and that should fix it. Let's just see it in Unity before we can make sure. So I'm just gonna hit play. Now the enemy is going to look at our player and start producing projectile. So that's one thing I wanted to clear up. Now let's make our enemy search for the ammo pickups on the scene, move towards them, collect them, and only after doing so will we make our enemy able to produce projectiles. So I'm just going to stop the scene here and go to our enemy controller script. Here we are going to need two variables. One is to store the ammo count that the enemy has. So I'm just going to declare an integer variable, ammo count, and set it to 0 initially. The other one is going to be an array of pickup game objects so that we can get all the pickup game objects that are available on the scene and load to it. Then the enemy will be able to iterate through these ammo, find the nearest one and move towards it and pick it up. So it's going to be pickup, and I'm going to call it ammo list. I'm going to set the maximum to 5. This is because the maximum number of ammo pickups on our scene at a time is going to be 5. This is when we start the game, and after either the player or the enemy has picked up all these 5 ammo pickups, the next round, the number of ammo pickups that is going to be moved from our pool back to our scene is 2. Please watch my video on object pooling if you haven't. That's where I explain or set these things up. So in our update, all we need to do is load all the ammo pickups that are available on the scene to this ammo list. So that's just ammo list equal to find objects of type. Here it is going to be find objects and not object. That's because we are going to search for multiple objects of type pickup. And that's pretty much it. So now if we head back to Unity, we can see that our enemy controller script has a ammo list array, and its size is 0 initially, but when we hit play, it's going to change to 5 and load all the ammo pickups, that is 5 of these ammo pickups, onto our ammo list array we just created. Now let's try make a enemy search for ammo pickups. Before that, I'm just going to clear these codes here and make them more readable to users. So I'm just going to take all these and cut it, and I'm going to create a new bool variable here, bool, and this should be for chasing our player. So he's chasing, and I'm going to set it to this, and inside our if I'm just going to give is chasing. Now this code is more easier to read, and here I'm gonna take everything up inside this if else and move it to another bool. I'm gonna call is attacking, and I'm going to set it to this, and I'm just going to use this is attacking inside our if else if. And here inside our if, we want to move back to our original position, so I'm just going to add bool, move to original pose, and I'm going to set this to what we had in our if here. Now that's more readable code. And I'm going to add another variable of bool type that is going to be search for bullets, search for ammo. So we are going to trigger this if our ammo count is less than or equal to 0. And that's going to be our priority, because without ammo we are not going to be able to make our enemy shoot. So I'm just going to put it at the top here. So if search for ammo, we're gonna call a method inside this if, else we're gonna do everything else. So what we need to do in the search for ammo is we need to make our enemy find the nearest ammo pickup and move towards it. So I'm just going to call a method here, which I haven't made yet, find ammo. And I'm just going to hit alt enter and generate the method. So there's our method here. So all we need to do in our find ammo is make our enemy search for the nearest ammo and make it move towards it. So we are going to need a pickup variable to store the nearest ammo. So I'm gonna call it nearest ammo. And I'm gonna set it to null. We are gonna need a float to store the minimum distance. So that is the distance to the closest ammo, so mindest. And I'm going to set it to mathf.infinity so that it is a really large distance initially, and then we can iterate through our ammo list and find the closest ammo, set its distance to minimum distance. So for each pickup ammo in our ammo list, we are going to need a distance, so float distance, I'm just going to call it dist, and this is going to be the distance of our enemy towards each of these ammo inside our ammo list. So that is vector 3 dot distance, ammo dot transform dot position, comma transform dot position. So we are going to check if this distance is less than our minimum distance. And if it is so, we are going to set the minimum distance to this distance. And we are going to set the nearest ammo to this ammo. Now we are going to need a NAMESH agent is stopped to set to false so that our enemy can move with its NAMESH agent. And here all we need to do is set the destination to this ammo's position. So here we're just going to copy and paste it over here and change it from player.transform position to nearest ammo.transform.position. This should be working fine. Let's see if enemy is moving towards the nearest ammo. So when we hit play, we can see that enemy is not attacking the player, even though it is in attacking distance, it's just moving towards the nearest ammo. So we have a enemy over here. Let's see if it is having. Yeah, we have our ammo pickup. And if we move the ammo pickup, the enemy is moving towards it as well. So everything's working fine for now. Now let's make our enemy collect these ammo pickups instead of just moving towards them and start firing at our player. Let's open up a pickup script. What we already got in our pickup script is we got a count variable, and if we check our prefab ammo pickup, we have set the count to 5. So inside the on trigger, that is, if the pickup comes in contact with another game object, we are checking if the other game object has a movement script. That's basically just checking if the other game object is a player or not. And we are calling the set ammo count on the movement script and passing this count variable, which is 5. And if we check the movement script, we got the set ammo count here. All we are doing inside our set ammo count is incrementing the ammo count of the player by the count we are passing, that is 5. So the player will be able to shoot 5 times. What we need in our enemy controller is a similar method. So I'm just going to cut or copy this set ammo count from our movement script and paste it inside our enemy controller. And since this is basically just checking if the other game object is player or not, I'm just going to cut this from here. And there's a better way to check if the other game object is player or not, and that's by comparing its tag. So I'm just going to add a boolean variable is player and set it to true if other dot compare tag is player, if the other game object's compare tag is player. And we are going to need a similar variable for our enemy, so I'm just going to add bool is enemy equal to other dot compare tag enemy. And we don't need to set these tags on our game object because we have already set them up in our previous videos. So please make sure to watch those previous videos before you come to this tag. Our player has got a tag of player, and our enemy has got a tag of enemy. So this should be working. And here we need to check if the other game object is a player, is either a player or an enemy. And again, we need to check if the other game object is player. And if it is player, we are going to call set ammo count in our movement script. And if it is enemy, we are going to call the same method, but from our enemy controller. Let's also not forget about decrementing the ammo count on our enemy controller when your enemy is firing bullets. All we need to do for that is we need to decrement the ammo count. So ammo count minus minus inside our start attacking method, and it should be working fine. So that's it for today's video. Thank you all for watching. If you like my content, please subscribe to my channel and smash that like button. Good luck, you all. Peace.